الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وبعد. Journey to the Hereafter. Today inshallah ta'ala we're talking about what's after النفخ في الصور. Last week we were talking about this particular angel Israfil alayhi salam, who is in charge of blowing the trumpet or the horn to call the people to go first, for two times. The first time, فَفَزِعَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ. First time, everybody is going to get frightened and die. And second time, everybody is going to stand up and respond to the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what comes next in order? Are they your child, right?
Sorry?
Your child in the car?
My wife.
Khalas, sit down. Alhamdulillah. Somebody left his child in the car. So I thought that's your child.
Your dad.
They call the cops, they're going to arrest him. It's horrible.
No, maybe they arrest us.
What if something happened to the car?
Yeah. Anyway. What comes next? So, just again, as usual, I try to bring this up. When you listen to this, or to these events or incident and orders, try to imagine this, because it's beyond, nobody know exactly how it looks like. So leave the, let yourself imagine as much as you can how it looks like, unless we have a certain text telling us exactly that will happen, as we will have today inshallah ta'ala. Other than that, most of it, it's ghaibiyat, unseen, that we have to believe in it as it came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Israfil alayhi salam will blow that horn. And by the way, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that's one of the hadith that I mentioned last week, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the authentic hadith, كيف آمن, how I feel secure or safe while I know for sure that Israfil alayhi salam already got the horn and يعني is waiting, just waiting for the order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to start the qiyam. What comes after blowing the horn and everybody comes stand up, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَإِذَا هُمْ قِيَامٌ يَنْظُرُونَ, is Al-Hashr. Today we're talking about Al-Hashr, not where we're going to be resurrected. I'm going to be talking about the Al-Hashr itself, the resurrection itself, how it happens and what is going to happen to this world quickly. طبعاً not everything we can cover, and inshallah ta'ala after where, that's one of the points that we raised last week, are we going to be resurrected on this earth or somewhere else? What's going to happen to this earth or not? طيب. يأمر الله تبارك وتعالى إسرافيل أن ينفخ في الصور نفخة البعث والإحياء فتخرج الأرواح من الصور بإذن ربها وتذهب كل روح إلى جسدها. You guys know that some people believe that after you die, your soul, they have to burn your, maybe I mentioned before, they have to burn your body because this soul has to go to somebody else. You know that, right? Especially if you're coming from this area, part of the world, that's what believe it. Everybody has his own soul and this soul is waiting for him. That's why when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders Israfil to blow the horn, all the souls will come out from the horn and it will go to each body or its body. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will revive the bodies and the ruh will go to the body. تَعُودُ كُلُّ رُوحٍ إِلَى جَسَدِهَا وَتُزَلْزِلْ الأرض زلزالها. The next thing that will happen after the blowing the trumpet or the horn is that this, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Zalzala, إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا. This earth will be shaking, will have that huge earthquake from which everything inside this earth will come out. Like what?
Volcano.
I said imagination, mashallah. The imagination works now. Like what? What's inside the earth right now that when it starts shaking and have this earthquake will come out? What? You! The first thing is you. Where are you gonna be? In the منها خلقناكم وفيها نعيدكم, right? ومنها نخرجكم تارة أخرى. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. Said, we have created you from this soil, from this ground, from this dirt. You're coming back to it, and we will revive you again from it. You'll come again from that. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked or ordered the earth to have this earthquake. طيب فتخرج من في جوفها ما أثقلها من الإنس والجن والحيوان لأنها أجابت أمر ربها ووحيه لها ويومئذ. And here is something that you have to be aware of. يومئذ تحدث تغيرات كونية في جميع العالم ويجد الإنسان. What will happen at that moment that this big change in the whole universe, and you will be seeing that today you're reading it, you're reading about it, you're imagining it, but at that moment you will be seeing exactly what's happening again. يعني you can't tell exactly today what's going to be, but as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned of the ayat, I'm going to mention some of the ayat of the change that will happen to the whole universe, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول ونفخ فإذا نفخ في الصور نفخة واحدة وحملت الأرض والجبال فدكتا دكة واحدة فيومئذ وقعت الواقعة وانشقت السماء فهي يومئذ واهية والملك على أرجائها. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning that the change will happen to starting from blowing the horn, will happen to the earth, will happen to the mountain, will happen to the sun, will happen to the sky, will happen to everything, all of the creature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول إِذَا السَّمَاءُ انفطرت. إِذَا السَّمَاءُ انفطرت. طبعاً أنا بقولها انفطرت يعني إذا السماء انفطرت يعني عشان القراءة صحيحة يعني. And look that the sky will be who knows the meaning of انفطر. Huh? Exactly. It will be in parts, will be torn apart, like Sheikh Ali said. إِذَا الشَّمْسُ كُوِّرَتْ وَإِذَا النُّجُومُ انْكَدَرَتْ. All of these change will happen to everything around you, and you will be seeing that because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revived you again. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you life again. وترى الجبال تحسبها جامدة يومئذ تبدل الأرض يسأل أيان يوم القيامة ويسألونك عن الجبال فقل ينسفها ربي نسفا. These huge mountains that you see today will be smashed, will be turned into هباء منثورة, will be turned to that little sand, and will be going to the earth, and the earth will be leveled. It's not gonna لا ترى فيها عوجا ولا أمتا. The whole earth will be leveled or مسطحة يعني flat. It will be flat. Everything will come back the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. طيب. There are many ayat about this, but let's go to the ahadith, because the ahadith will tell you more about the description of the resurrection. How we're going to be resurrected. Sayyidina Sahl ibn Sa'd radiallahu anhu يقول قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يحشر الناس يوم القيامة على أرض بيضاء عفراء كقرصة النقي ليس فيها علم لأحد. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith that the people will be resurrected on a reddish white ground, earth. Exactly like when you get a very pure bread from a very pure flour. Something, the word بيضاء طبعا عفراء هي التي ليست ناصعة البياض. يعني it's not bright. It's white but it's not bright. يعني you can say close to the color of the bread. The Prophet ﷺ said that in the hadith. عفراء كالنقي. Exactly like that, pure bread. لا علم فيها لأحد. Nobody had stepped on it before. طب it tells you that, which is I'm going to, يعني إن شاء الله تعالى, maybe next week, will explain that it's not any of this of the grounds or the earth that we already stepped on or the areas that the people lived on. Hadith is clear. لا علم فيها لأحد. ومعنى ليس فيها علم لأحد يعني لم توطأ قبل ذلك فليس فيها أثر لأحد. Nobody has touched it before the day of resurrection. وعن أنس رضي الله عنه أن رجلا قال يا رسول الله قال الله تعالى الذين يحشرون على وجوههم إلى جهنم أيحشر الكافر على وجهه. سيدنا أنس بن مالك in the authentic hadith he said, طب يعني احنا بنقول ايه, blowing that trumpet people will come from their you know from under the ground, whether it's a grave or whatever it is, everybody will go, his soul will match his body, they will walk, right? Not everybody will be walking, by the way, in the resurrection. Not everybody will be actually resurrected walking on his feet. The hadith, again, Sayyidina Anas ibn Malik said, I like this. Wallah, everybody is actually is living this moment. Is living, by the way, grammatically is wrong. I know that, but sorry. Everybody now lives the moment that, yeah, this will happen. The Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, a man came to him and said, Ya Rasulullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, الَّذِينَ يُحْشَرُونَ عَلَى وُجُوهِهِمْ إِلَى جَهَنَّمْ. Those who will be resurrected on their faces towards Jahannam. أَيُحْشَرُ النَّاسُ عَلَى وُجُوهِهِمْ. Ya Rasulullah, will some people be resurrected on their faces? فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أليس الذي أمشاه على رجلين في الدنيا قادرا على أن يمشيه على وجهه؟ قال قتادة حين بلغه هذا الحديث بلى وعزة ربنا. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said that, don't you believe that the one who made him walk on his foot on this life is able to force him, خلي بالك, even the text in Arabic say يمشيه, that he will force him to walk on his face on the day of judgment. Then Sayyidina Qatada radiallahu anhu, when he heard the hadith, he said, Bala wa izzati rabbina. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with his mighty, with his power, is able to do that. طيب. وعن ابن عباس radiallahu anhu, I'm delaying one of the hadith that I always used to hear, and you cannot ever imagine that you hear this hadith, excuse me, reported by Sayyidah Aisha, and you don't imagine the situation. I'm delaying it. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, قال قام فينا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بموعظة فقال. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one day gave us a reminder saying, أيها الناس, O people, حتى عدس from the biryani man. He eating biryani until 11 p.m. last night. La hawla. I was eating with him, that's why. Ya ayyuhan nasu, in تحشرون إلى الله حفاة عراة غرلا. O people, you will be resurrected towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment. Hufat, barefoot or barefooted, whatever. Ura, naked. Ghurlan, who knows the meaning of ghurlan? Huh?
Uncircumcised.
Allahu Akbar, mashallah. Yeah, the biryani works, man. So, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ghurlan, ghurlan, that you're coming back to your nature. You're born uncircumcised. You have to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way you were created. Ghurlan. No? ما مصدرها؟ مصدر ايه؟ يعني ايه مصدرها؟ مش عارف العربي بتاعها؟
مصدر
ايه؟
مصدر
ايه؟
مصدر غرلا ايه؟ غرلا يعني ايه؟ كلمة معناها؟
غارة لا مثلا؟ لا needs بحث.
I'm just wondering about the source of the word.
He's asking about the root of the word غرل. If anybody can help us with the Arabic here. Maybe Hanif. Not? Okay. طيب. We'll do some research on that inshallah ta'ala. جزاك الله خيرا جميعا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith, كما بدأنا أول خلق نعيد وعدا علينا إنا كنا فاعلين. Exactly as we started you in the beginning, we'll return you to your nature. ألا وإن أول الخلق أنت again and again and again. Imagine the situation. Imagine the stand between the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine that you are being pushed with the whole world. The only thing I thought of, one time, a friend of mine was coming for the first time from from Egypt to Nevada. Nevada is ahsan min al-asima al-lana kutubi. So, and then he came. The first impression he had in the airplane, when you are on the airplane for a long time, he came and he said, "Ya Sheikh, you know what? Something like attracted me in the airplane. What's it?" He said, "Subhanallah, all of these people will go to the fire." That's the only thing that he came to his mind. Yeah. When you're close to, when you are on the air, you're close to, most of the people, they consider themselves close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, khalas. That's why some people, they sleep. If I go sleeping. Okay? For the same here, that today when I was reading this hadith, I thought of everybody, every human being that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created will be there. Some people that you wish today to meet, some people, we were in London a few weeks ago and some of the friends, they wanted to meet Muhammad Salah. You will see him over there. Some people, they want to see Michael Jackson. You will see him over there. طبعا, nobody will recognize anybody. Nobody's not, think of it. I'm actually joking now. But look at the continuation of the hadith. When you are looking to the first one to get his body covered, who? Have you read this hadith? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not. No. Ibrahim alayhi salam. وأول ألا وإن أول الخلائق يكسى إبراهيم عليه السلام. The first one to get his body covered will be Ibrahim عليه السلام. ألا وإنه سيجاء برجال. هنا بدأ. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم is looking at us, at you personally. He's expecting you to be following his way. But unfortunately, some of the Muslims, they actually left the religion. And they're not followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They don't care. They don't know anything about it. They left. He's not going to be happy. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول, أَلَا وَإِنَّهُ سَيُجَاءُ بِرِجَالٍ مِّنْ أُمَّتِي فَيُؤْخَذُ بِهِمْ ذَاتُ الشِّمَالِ فَأَقُولُ. A group of people from my ummah, they will be taken to the right, or to the left hand side, the left side. They will be from the people of the left. أهل الشمال. فأقول. The Prophet ﷺ said that I will say, صلى الله عليه وسلم, يا ربي أصحابي Those are my companions. Those are my followers. فيقول سبحانه وتعالى يا محمد إنك لا تدري ما أحدثوا بعدك. You don't know what they did after you. What they innovated after you. What they created after you. What they changed after you. فأقول كما قال العبد الصالح. Then at this moment, I will say like the righteous servant when he said, وكنت عليهم شهيدا ما دمت فيهم. Who is this?
Isa.
Isa, Isa. Yesterday I was talking with Brother Ab about this ayah. And don't memorize Quran with, like, I understand the beginning of the ayah, then I can guess the end of the ayah. For in this context, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in Surah Al-Ma'idah, إِن تُعَذِّبْهُمْ. Who knows the ayah? فَإِنَّهُمْ عِبَادٌ وَإِن تَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Right? No. It's not الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Don't ever continue with, because it makes sense, man. الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ. No. الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. You're the mighty. You're the one who has the power. You're the one who is the all-wise, who can punish, who can give rahmah, who can forgive them. It's all totally up to you. We're saying here, and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will say to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you don't know, ya Muhammad, what they did after you? And then Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will say like Isa alayhi salam said, وَكُنْتُ عَلَيْهِمْ شَهِيدًا مَا دُمْتُ فِيهِمْ. I was a witness on them until I died, until I left them. إلى قوله العزيز الحكيم. These are the ayat that I mentioned. قال فيقال لي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it will be said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إنهم لم يزالوا مرتدين على أعقابهم منذ فارقتهم. زاد في رواية فأقول سحقا سحقا. Don't be from those people. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all from this category of people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that they kept leaving the religion after you. They kept returning and going back and leaving the religion after you left them. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul suhqan suhqan, I don't need them, let them go to the hellfire. طيب. This is the hadith I was referring to earlier. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who always, when you hear a hadith, try to follow the way of the Sahaba. When they used to hear a hadith or listen to a hadith from the Prophet ﷺ, they used to always, if they need to comment, they comment right away. If they have a question, they ask the Prophet ﷺ the question right away. If it doesn't make sense to his limited understanding, he asks right away. يعني سيدة عائشة رضي الله عنها, in one of the hadith, Nabi ﷺ is saying, مَنْ أَحَبَّ لِقَاءَ اللَّهِ أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ لِقَاءَ. Right? Whoever loves to meet with Allah, Allah loves to meet with him. You and I, we listen to this, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, I love. But do you hate to die or not? Who hates to die now? Nobody? Put it back.
Allah yahdik.
For she was more realistic than all of us. She told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, wa min minna la yakra al-mawt. We're human beings and we all hate death. Who said that I love to meet with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Nobody loves to die. Don't cheat yourself. Hatta even in Islam, it's not even good to wish to die. And it's not good to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes, yani if your wife has 3-4 kids, she will keep making dua against herself. Ya Rabbi khudni wa ri'ahni min ashkalli. You know, this is not from Islam. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم is talking about this. The same thing, Sayyidah Aisha, she told him, you know what? You know, we don't like to die. Then he explained to her what he means, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Here in the same, in this context that we're talking about, getting resurrected in that shape, in that look, what is it again? What is it? How are we going to be resurrected?
Barefooted.
Naked.
Gorla.
Khalas, عشان جمال ما يزعلش. حتى ما نجيب له المصدر بتاعه. وعن عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول يحشر الناس حفاة عراة غرلا. قالت عائشة فقلت يا رسول الله الرجال. Have you ever thought of it? الرجال والنساء جميعا ينظر بعضهم إلى بعض. يعني يا رسول الله, where are we ladies? So Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is talking again in front of Sayyidina Aisha. She's listening to him. He's saying, the people will be resurrected barefooted, naked, and uncircumcised. Then Sayyidina Aisha, she said, Ya Rasulullah, yani are you talking about men and women naked, looking at one another? What has happened? What do you think? Absolutely will happen. طبعا, everybody now is looking like, Alhamdulillah, am I covered well or not? Yes, that's the nature that we have. That's a good nature that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us. That's satr al-awra, one of the conditions of the validity of your ibadah. One of the, حتى subhanAllah, for some people, when you read about people who don't have religion, the first thing they do, they cover their themselves. It's nature, human nature. But at that moment, look at what the Prophet ﷺ says. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, الْأَمْرُ أَشَدُّ أَنْ يَغُمَّهُمْ ذَلِكَ. What do you think will make you, other than those crazy people who go and they have the show for naked people, forget about those people. They're okay, they're free to do whatever they want. That's my opinion, official opinion. Everybody is free to do whatever you want. Edit, man. No, I'm serious. We have to edit this. We'll be in trouble. Imagine what will make you go in that street now naked and walk in the street naked. What? What can force you to go outside in public naked? What, Suleiman? What do you think? Money? I don't think money. I'm asking you as a person. You yourself. I'm not.
If I'm crazy.
Yeah, somebody lost his mind. What else?
Like a tsunami or earthquake.
Exactly. Something huge. Earthquake. Tsunami, like Sheikh Hussain said.
So
the whole house is falling, something collapsed.
Sheikh, tsunami is coming, so I take off my clothes and go.
No. You are. No, man. He means that if you are in the washroom, taking shower and it happens at the same time. But what will force you to do that today is something over your, something huge that you cannot, you're not able actually to cover yourself. It's outside your capacity and out of your control. Nothing but this. Other than that, you will never do it if you are a man that has a sound mind and brain. Sayyidina Aisha is asking the Prophet ﷺ, Ya Rasulullah, are you talking about men and women together going out and looking at one another? Nabi ﷺ يقول, Ya Aisha, it's the situation at that moment is greater than that nature that we have. That you're not going to be even looking at anything. You're not going to be even caring at anything or to anything or giving care to anything. All what you will be caring about or looking for, how to survive, how to save myself from wal'iyadu billah being in the hellfire. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه. I'm going to more in details about how people will be resurrected. أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه قال, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, يحشر الناس يوم القيامة ثلاثة أصناف أو ثلاثة أصناف مبني المجهول. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said that the people on the day of judgment will be resurrected in three categories. صنف أو صنفا مشاع. The first category, some people will be walking. وَصِنْفًا رُكْبَانًا. Some other category of people will be riding or, you know, driving a nice car. وَصِنْفًا وَالْعِيَادَ بِاللَّهِ عَلَىٰ وُجُوهِهِمْ. The third category, those people will be, again, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, will be taken forced walk on their faces to the hellfire. قِيلَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَكَيْفَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَىٰ وُجُوهِمْ قَالَ إِنَّ الَّذِي أَمْشَاهُمْ عَلَىٰ أَقْدَمِهِمْ. The same thing happened in this hadith. The question came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, how those people, والله العظيم, أخي, I've read this ayah hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of times. I didn't even يعني, think about it. Sometimes we just read the ayat. I didn't think about it. يعني, يسحبون على وجههم, they will be taken on their faces. خلاص. يعني, one side of it, it's belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is able to do it. And the other side is that we don't contemplate that much in the ayat. However, the Sahaba, once we hear, they listen to the ayah, they ask right away how those people will be walking on their faces. The Prophet ﷺ said that the one who made them walk on their foot or feet on this dunya will force them to walk on their faces on the akhirah. From what we had now, that a great change will happen to the whole universe. People will come out, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمِنْهَا نُخْرِجُكُمْ تَارَةً أُخْرَى. They will be walking towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're lucky if you are walking. Some other people, al-'ayadu billah, will be يعني forced to walk on their faces. Al-ba'athu, يعني I'm going to summarize يعني in brief, inshallah ta'ala, the point that we take. I want to let you guys go to the soccer game. Abdullah Rahman?
No, I'm sick.
السلام عليك عبدالله. احنا عملنا حسابك يا عم والشباب مستنينا كده. طيب ابن عمر كمان مشي. طيب. ان the first point that we highlighted today, البعث يحدث بعد النفخ في الصور مباشرة. So I have النفخ في الصور, blowing the trumpet. Number two, or next in order, is the resurrection. ان الارض عند البعث تضطرب من داخلها الباطني وتزلزل زلزلة عظيمة تخرج كل ما في باطنها. With the resurrection, after the نفخ في الصور, this earth will have this great like earthquake and shake, and everything inside the earth will come out. كما قال الله تبارك وتعالى يومئذ تحدث أخبار. By the way, one of the things that will come with the people from the earth is the news of those people. يعني, so and so was inside my, or under the ground, or under me, if the earth is talking now, and he did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever. يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا. The earth will tell everything about you. بَأَنَّ رَبَّكَ أَوْحَى. Who tells her to do, to say all of that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. إذا خرج الناس. طب.
So the earth saying everything you do, so everybody will hear what you did, or is it to only Allah?
That's a good question. I don't know. I didn't think about it. يعني سليمان is saying that when the earth, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Zalzala, يومئذ تحدث أخبارها. يعني تحدث meaning that it will say it loud. الله أعلم. طيب. No. Who is talking when the earth will talk loud and everybody will hear, or just will be mentioning that to Allah. I think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to her to say it loud, so everybody will hear it. Allah. Number three, when the people will be asked to come out from the earth, everybody will be frightened, everybody will be scared. لا يحزنهم الفزع الأكبر except أولياء الله تبارك وتعالى. The awliya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طبعاً when we say awliya Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we're not talking about the يعني some of the crazy mentalities that they have their sheikh and he is my wali and I'm gonna take the barakah from him. You take the barakah, I come here, inshallah I'll give you the barakah. Inshallah ta'ala, if you need the barakah. Okay, but it's not those awliya. أَلَا إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ. يعني you can be yourself a wali from awliya Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. It's not a certain person, yeah, this is wali from awliya Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the qabr, the grave of wali of awliya Allah. Nobody knows that. And nobody can describe a certain person. It's a description for a certain category of people, not a certain person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqul, those people will be secured, will be safe from that fear when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks the angel to make to blow the horn. لا يحزنهم الفزع الأكبر وتتلقاهم الملائكة. And the angels will receive them. هذا يومكم الذي كنتم توعدون. This is your day, the day that you were promised. نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا. طيب. Everybody, again, we're talking about every human being will hear the call, will hear the horn, and will respond right away. And we walk silently, attentively. لذلك الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول وخشعت الأصوات للرحمن فلا تسمعوا إلا همسا. Everybody will be walking like that. Nobody was gonna talk. خلاص يعني من وجل from the greatness of that moment, nobody can talk. فلا تسمعوا إلا همسا. Everybody is walking towards Allah سبحانه وتعالى. طيب. There are, as I said, and I said quickly, there are lots of cosmetic or universal change that will happen at that moment. As we said, when the nujum kadarat, it happened to the stars, it happened to the sky, it will happen to the sun, it will happen to the moon, it will happen to the mountains, it will happen to everything. ومنها طيب يحشر المتقون ويجمعون في أرض الموقف مكرمين كما تكرم الوفود العزيزة أما الكفار فإنهم يحشرون أذلاء عطاشة لا يرتوون ولا يرحمون. So the believers will be resurrected in a way, in a very honorable way. They're actually the visitors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The kuffar, again as we said, on their faces, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran. This ayah in Surah Qaf, and the next point reminds me with some of the embassies. If you're going to apply for a visa, they take you, I've been to this myself here, they take you an officer ahead of you and an officer at the back, and they يسوقونك. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about this. وَجَاءَتْ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَعَهَا سَائِقٌ وَشَهِيدٌ. Everybody, every human being, every soul will go to meet with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with two things, or two subjects, whatever it is. An angel to lead that soul towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and an angel as a witness. Yeah, no, I didn't do it. Oh, you did it. Look, it happened. I'm here. I wrote everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the angel to write everything. سائق, a leader, or a lead you, and the other one is looking, I'm here, writing everything. That's the ayah in Surah Qaf. وَجَاءَتْ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَعَهَا سَائِقٌ وَشَهِيدٌ وَفِي هَذَا الْيَوْمُ تُبَدَّلُ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرَ الْأَرْضِ وَفِي تَنْشَقِّ السَّمَاءِ النَّاسُ يُحْشَرُونَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ كَمَا قُلْنَا حُفَاةً عُرَاةً غُرْلًا كَمَا أَخْبَرَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. Now they got resurrected. Where, how we're gonna be standing, what will happen in that moment in the resurrection before the hisab. So again, look at the order. نفخ في الصور. No, the order be before, but you die, we take you to your grave, then you are in the grave between the death and the qiyamah, and that's the barzakh that we talked about. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the angel to blow the horn. And then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered everybody to be resurrected to a place and to an area. And what will happen while we're standing in between the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And then after that, the hisab. These are, inshallah ta'ala, the two main points that I'll try my best, inshallah ta'ala, to cover next week. Al-hash al-ahwal, aw ahwal al-mawqif, the greatness of that stand, that resurrection, and al-hisab, the reckoning or the questioning between the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll try our best to do that next week, inshallah ta'ala, on Saturday. Any concern, any question, any comment, anything about it? Fadl Suleiman.
Just mentioned that, just a comment, I don't know.
Yeah, go ahead.
And then I have a question next. Every human being is coming with two angels.
Yeah.
So, subhanAllah, that means starting from Adam all the way to the end of the world.
Yeah, imagine how many angels.
How many angels?
Yeah. ألا تعلم يا سليمان أن البيت المعمور البيت المعمور الذي في السماء السابعة. You know البيت المعمور؟ والبيت المعمور right? الله سبحانه وتعالى says والبيت المعمور يدخله كل يوم 70,000 ملك لا يخرجون إلى يوم القيامة. Every day لا يخرجون منه. Sure. Yeah, يعني هم they're inside.
Yeah, they don't go back.
They don't go back. You mean?
Yeah.
طيب. But they're not. There is no duplicate of the angels. That those 70,000, other than the 70,000 that go the next day, the next day, the day, the day. But why you have to go far? Yeah. Don't you have two angels now? With more than two angels. You have the right and the left angels. And we have the كِرَامًا وَإِنَّ عَلَيْكُمْ لَحَافِظِينَ كِرَامًا كَاتِبِينَ.
Do we have شياطين too?
شياطين lots. We have lots of شياطين around us. Don't worry about this.
So we have two angels شياطين.
No, we don't have شياطين. We have قرناء. No, but we don't have شياطين. The same number of angels, no?
But
doesn't
everybody has
شياطين? شيطان
said
شياطين. Yeah, but that's not. يعني the shaitan is with you, but not there is no one assigned for this job and this job. Those who are writing, those who are protecting, those who are actually with you are angels, not shaitan. But the shaitan around you, يجري من ابن آدم مجرى الدم من العروق. يعني he comes with you, he's with you.
There is one assigned for us, the
قريب. قريب. Yeah, that's the only one that I told him. I told Salman قريب.
Well, I saw
your
قريب.
فصرع فصرع.
Finally, you were mentioning the signs of awliya.
Yeah.
Yes. So that being said, right? No, can we identify and say, oh, this bird is awliya?
I don't think so. That's absolutely. And you're talking about Jamal? Maybe no. Jamal. He's my friend. So.
So there are no signs to indicate, to direct us to say that this guy is awliya.
Again,
that is not the case. How can
somebody the way you say if that? Yani exactly. If you're talking and you're saying somebody is a kafir, you can say this particular person is a kafir, but the one who does this is a kafir. So the same thing, if somebody is, again, we deal with some people like that. There are some people that when you deal with them, you feel that those people are from awliya. But you cannot say that he is a wali.
So how can we find awliya to worship them? How can we find awliya?
To worship them? That's nice. After the halaqa, I'll show you. You know, after the halaqa, inshallah, we'll show you the way of the awliya to worship them.
Because you know, some of us have special reverence to awliya, where some of our Muslim brothers have special
reverence. And hatta even when we quote from our history, I remember most of the khutbah yesterday that I had, most of it was statements and sayings of as-salihin. We say ahadu as-salihin, ahadu as-salihin, ahadu as-salaf. I never said that ahadu al-awliya. So we don't say that this statement or saying of awliya from awliya Allah. We say one of the righteous people. He was considered to be a righteous person, but not wali. Al-awliya daraja, it's a level, it's a degree comes after al-anbiya, sadiqin al-shuhada. Yani it's not something that you just can give it to somebody, certain person. However, there are people like that. Who al-Khadr at the end of the day was not a prophet. And he was not a prophet. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted him, I want Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam to recognize this fact that he is one of our awliya, one of our ibad salihin, and he can teach you. Okay? طيب يا شباب جزاكم الله خيرا. I'll see you inshallah ta'ala. Are we changing Salat al-Fajr tomorrow?
Yeah.